Hey guys, hope you're well. Okay, so I have to be honest with you guys. I filmed a video not too long ago about me breaking up with fashion and removing myself from the fashion social media discussion. Now here's the thing, Fashion Week is happening right now and I've been invited to a couple of presentations and I'm very interested in attending these events because it gives me the opportunity to discover new brands, new designers, new collections, and I'm really excited about that. Now, does that make me a hypocrite? Depends on how you see it, but I really wanted to take the time to, I'm being more mindful with how I want to present fashion on my channel. I still think that what I said in the video is still valid. Okay, with that being said, let's get ready. Okay, I have an idea of using the tie as a scarf, but I do always do it like this. But I wanted to know if there was a possibility of using it as, I don't know, like a, where this can be like this. But then I don't know how ugly this is. Is this working? Wait, hold on, let me see on the mirror. I think it's the knot here that's a bit awkward. But then if I'm wearing, actually it's not bad. It's not bad, it's just, what am I doing? Do I look crazy? But I think it wouldn't look as bad if I have a shirt and then I can just hide this under the collar. But then it would be weird because you have, this is so complicated. Okay, I'm thinking if I put this is a sweater, and then if I have this underneath, does it do something? It's not horrible. Oh guys, I don't know. Actually, it's not bad. I'm not hating this actually. And then at the back it would be okay. It's not, I don't hate this. These colors go together, but this sweater is too long and this won't peak. I'm overthinking. Okay, what do I want to wear? How about, let's ask that question actually. Oh, you know what? I'll wear this. Forget about the tie, because I don't have a brown tie. If I had a brown tie, it would have been so helpful. Actually, I don't hate this. I'll have the pants and the skirt, but as a top, I don't know what to do with the top. Okay, I'm just pulling out stuff, but I don't have anything. Okay. I think I have an idea. I don't hate this, actually. Okay, this is not bad. This is a good color. I can do like this. But I feel like I want something to go on the side. Okay, how am I seeing this? Okay, this is really good. I think it's also the fact that this is very, very loose. And I think it's a bit more tight. And then on the back it will be like this. But I don't think if I have my coat on, people will see this. I just have blue peeking through. This is usually horrendous. Yeah, no. But it's like this part where I'm like, okay, at this point. Okay, guys, I know. I think I have an idea. Okay. And then I'll just wear this. Okay. Do I want to keep it inside? Oh, outside is nice. I'll do a side tie. I don't know why I'm doing my tie. No, this is like too bulky. Okay, I'm really happy. Okay, I think this is my opinion of rings. My hair is a mess. But I don't care. Okay, I have to go. I'm like dancing, but I'm late. I'll see you guys at the venue. Awesome. I'm back. Hey guys, I want to do a proper summary of the fashion week. And I actually started this notebook where I just go through, like, little reviews of the fashion collection that I've seen, even though I'm not a specialist, but I think going through this exercise does give me the opportunity to just reflect on what I've seen and not just be like, okay, take pictures and then I'm done. The first event I attended was the EasyDo pop-up show. And essentially, EasyDo, she's a Chinese-Canadian fashion designer and she's based in London. And she graduate from Saint-Tropez St. Martin's and Antwerp Royal Academy. So very prestigious fashion schools. So about the pop-up, it mainly featured the puffer jackets. So they were long versions, short versions, cropped versions, but they also had other pieces from her other collections, such as trousers and tops. From what I gathered online, she mainly uses cotton silk and a water repellent by stretch polyamide tech fabric that is used for comfort, for versatility and breathability. And the puffers do use that fabric, that polyamide tech fabric, and inside there's duck down and feather. So yeah, about the venue, it was a great venue. It felt quite spacious and there was a nice atmosphere. There were DJs with nice music, and what made me laugh that there was a little cigarette pot, like there was like a pot and then there were cigarettes, which was quite funny because, you know, it's like UK culture, European culture where people smoke a lot, so it was just like a little, I don't know. Anyways, I love the clothes. I got to try the puffer and it was so comfortable. Like I felt like I was in a cloud. Ugh. If I were to buy, hey. Ugh. It felt amazing. Well, what they told me was that, especially the blue one, I don't know about all the puffers, but it was reversible. So there was a light blue version and there was inside there was the dark blue. So you could just flip it. And the other pieces were high quality, original, very interesting, and it's unisex, so anyone could wear the pieces. The trousers and the top were minimal but timeless and modern, so that was also interesting. So in conclusion, I really did enjoy the pieces, and I also got to talk briefly with the designer. She's really nice, so I really had overall a really good time at the pop-up venue. Okay, second event was the Nosaki Ebography exhibition opening, and then the next day it was open to the public. So about the brand, it's a London-based luxury accessory leather brand that goes beyond creating leather goods, and it really focuses on the storytelling and the cultural expression through their innovative designs. And for this exhibition, it was really centered around the Able crossbody bag, where the core idea of the exhibition was to take the bag as a canvas for multiple creative interpretations, so sculptures, paintings, music, etc. So there were multiple artists from different backgrounds that really reimagined the iconic bag, and it just showed the different artistic mediums and perspective. I want to say that the exhibition was not only about the world of fashion and art colliding, but it really highlighted the brand's ethos of storytelling and cultural expression. About the venue, so I went to the venue with my friend. We got there at the beginning, I want to say, but there was already a line there, and we thought that we were going to wait a long time, but it was actually, the line was going quite quickly. But I think the team, well, I think they said it during the presentation, but like as a like, hey, by the way guys, but I think they underestimated how many people were showing up, and the venue was quite small, so it was a bit difficult to really, like, there were a lot of people, so it was sometimes you felt stuck in one place because everyone was moving or there was a lot of people. So you had to be patient, okay? Just like step by step, ooh baby, gonna get to you good. Ooh baby, can I get to you good? Banana, banana, you always on my mind. Step. Okay. Anyways, yeah, so yeah, there were a lot of people. I also felt like there wasn't enough bags, but then it was also probably because the venue was small. So we got to see the paintings, the sculptures, but there, at some places they did feature the bag at the center, but I felt like if the venue was a bit bigger, I think they would have shown more bags so we could see the colors, but also really the structure and all this stuff. Or I think I wish that we got to interact more with the bag themselves, but then again, I understand the question of space and also how many people are there, like, are coming to the event, so I understand that. Other than that, the pieces themselves, so the paintings, the sculptures, were really interesting, and I really enjoyed how the artists differently incorporated the bags and the works. And then my favorite piece, it was a music composition by Jordan Fox, and essentially what he did, so he composed a music piece, an orchestral music piece, and then from there, he took excerpts of his piece and then arranged it as the form of the bag. Great. But overall, I really did enjoy the exhibition. It was really nice, and I think if you go online, you should really check the bags because the craftsmanship is really incredible.
There's a lot of sun coming in. So this is today's outfit. It's just the same skirt that I wore yesterday, and then I just added this skirt that I almost never wear, and then a black shirt. But it was like too loose, so I just put a tie behind, and yeah. Oh my god, look how so sun. The thing with this outfit is that depending on how you pose, like I was trying, like if I do this, it's like really nice. Like this. Oh my god, you can't see me. My confidence is just like, you just can't see anything.
Okay, so the next event I attended was the Noon by Knorr presentation. I want to say the brand is really luxury, but you really have to focus on what a confident woman would wear. Essentially, that's what I think of. What they do is really much so about combining relaxed silhouettes, but also taking specific references to menswear, such as tailored blazers, tailored trousers, oversized shirts, and all of that stuff. High quality fabrics. And the craftsmanship is really a focal element of the designs. About the collection, the inspiration from what I've seen on the press release was personal styles and work of fashion icons like Isabelle Adjani, Diana Vreeland, and elements from nature and traditional Bahrain, that's the country. Yes, key elements of the collection were a mix of styles, textures, interesting draping, tweeds, puff of colors, play on proportion, and then I will also say a modern interpretation of classic silhouettes. About the venue, it was at the Somerset House. The room we were in, I was thinking in French, piece, le pièce. The room we were in was like abandoned place, which I think I really like it because there wasn't like an overly, decorated room. I really got to focus on the collection in itself, and that was really great. There was also a coffee bar at the corner of the rooms. Well, it was rooms, multiple rooms, not one room. Okay, yeah. That was cool. And I think the highlight of this venue was it was sunny that day in London, and because it was sunny, you could actually see how the colors pop outside, because there's a difference on how a color looks when there's harsh light, artificial light, rather than when there's natural sunlight. So that was really nice, that was really cool. The accessories, oh, we'll talk about the clothes. The thing with presentations is that they will give you a time period where you can go and see the collection, and with that they show the collection multiple times during that time period, whereas a fashion show is you should be here at 6 p.m. and you see the collection once. With presentations, you can be there for like the entire time if you want to see the presentation like 10 times if you want to, or you can see 2-3 times, all that stuff. I saw the presentation 2 times and I saw them from different angles, and I think I preferred the second time because the first one you're just like all over the place, you just want to see the, like you just want to find the right spot, but it's not really the right spot. And I was in the room where it was like in a square, so people were like moving or just I felt like just a bit overwhelmed, whereas the second time I was there, I just went to the separate room, which was a bit smaller and where the photographs were. I just sat next, I was just like next to the photographs, and I got to see the pieces one by one. So I, that was better. The fact that I can see the collection multiple times, you really get the time to really take in the essence of the presentation, the collection. So, but overall, the collection was great. Great colors, great pieces. The craftsmanship is excellent, excellent. That's not how you emphasize on words. Excellent. And the pieces are timeless, elegant, unique, but also innovative and versatile. So although they really presented some pieces like as a one unit, you could have like the blazer with a pair of jeans, or the skirt with another top.
This is my fit for today. I have a sweater, I have this. I'm going out like this. Essentially it's like 10 degrees outside, so I should be fine. But I have my rings, like these. Oh shit, these are cool. These are cool. Okay. Oh fuck, these are fucking cool. They're so sick. Fuck, okay, I'm going out like this.
Okay, bye. I'll see you guys at the show. And then the last show, the last event that I attended, it was a really small fashion week, but I really loved it. I really enjoyed it in this way. I was not running around like doing like 30 things at the same time. I had two events max per day. I mean, I only attended four, but I think that's what my body could take, really. I don't know how I would do in September, but I'll have to see my strategy. Anyways, my last show was the Justin Cassan show, and about him, he's a fashion designer who uses his collection as an encouragement for people to be bold and express themselves through his designs. And he really does create collections that are very welcoming and exclusive to everyone. The collection was really nice. It took a fresh take on menswear, and it combined, you know, I would say classic tailoring, but also with modern features for a fun, urban, but also sophisticated touch. And the venue was at the Shoreditch Town Hall. And here's the thing, I think they should have utilized the stage, because the models were walking where the public would be, but there was a stage. I think it would have been even more fun if they utilized the stage for the show. Anyways, and there was also a balcony section. So the people who were in the balcony, I think, got to see, well, it depends where you are on the balcony, but the people on the first row of the balcony, or first two rows of the balcony, probably had the best view. The show featured a diverse range of models, and there was a vibrant atmosphere, and the music was pumping, like, boom, 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 boom. but it's actually a vibrant atmosphere that really highlighted the designs and the clothing. I think one small thing about the fashion show is that it's menswear and it's mainly men. Men walk fast. So I feel like, I don't know, it's not that I want to say like models should walk slower, because that's up to the designer, but I think the runway should have been a bit longer, so I got to see more of the designs. Sometimes I'm like, wait, you're already gone. No. You know, I think I would have wanted to be like, 2 more seconds, please. It was a really great show, and this is my first Justin Cassan show that I've attended in person, but I really do understand why the brand is really a well-established menswear brand. The collection that I saw really reinforced the reputation of Justin Cassan being a really great menswear designer. I'm really happy with my fashion week. I hope you liked the video, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.